Hi, my name is Diva and I love to eat. And today we're doing an ultimate Latin American food tour in Little Latin America in Montreal. Okay, for those of you who don't know, there's this community in Montreal where there is a bunch of Latin American businesses and restaurants, and it is known as Little Latin America. So basically in the 1980s, a bunch of Latin American businesses started opening up in this area near the Jean-Talon market. And it started off with this grocery store called Los Andes. And basically over time, a bunch of Latin American businesses and restaurants started opening up. And now this area is unofficially recognized as Little Latin America. It is one of my favorite areas of the city because of the food. It has such good food. And I thought it would be cool to do a little food tour where we explore some of the popular spots, some of my favorite spots. And yeah, I can't wait to take you guys along with me. It is a bit chilly in Montreal today, unfortunately, but it's okay. We're gonna have delicious Latin American food that will keep our bellies and our hearts warm. We're gonna start off with one of my favorite places called Marche Andes, and yeah, I can't wait to take you guys along with me. Let's go.
Por siempre en victoria y me ha hecho cabeza y no cola. En mi Cristo yo todo lo puedo. Jesús me dijo que me riera si el enemigo me tienta en la carrera. Y también me dijo no te mortifiques, que yo le envío mi sabi papá que lo pique en verdad.
Okay guys, we're at the first spot. This place is called Marche Andes. It's a restaurant, and just adjacent to it is a grocery store as well. And basically they have a bunch of different Latin American dishes from Peru, from Colombia, from Argentina. They have like things like empanadas, pupusas, tamales. They also have like main dishes as well, but mainly when I go is for the little things like empanadas, tamales, and pupusas. And it's so good. So let's go inside. So let's stop yapping and eat now because I am very hungry. Guys, we're inside the restaurant right now, and as you can see, it is very busy. I'm thinking of getting a tamale, a pupusa, and some empanadas. My favorite empanadas personally are from Bolivia. I think there's a specific name for them. I can't remember. No. Anyways, my favorite empanadas from the ones that I've tried so far have been from Bolivia, so that's what I'm gonna get. I'm gonna get a Mexican tamale, and we're gonna get some Salvadoran pupusa. So we're gonna eat from three countries in one place, which is so sick. So yeah.
Los muchachos en el drink del barrio nunca se doblan. Se mantienen en su tinta con un con de cariño. Con un iPhone en la mano y con el flow en la ropa. Con sus gorras de Big Papi, con sus tenis de Jordan. A las 2 de la mañana, en el medio del jaleo, aparece una jipeta, un billete de 500 y un deseo. Sale un individuo, lleva todo oscuro, con un billete de oro puro, a quien llama por apodo el rey del mar.
Okay guys, we've got all the dishes right here. I am literally dying right now. Like, I am dying to eat this. What should we start off with? I think we should start off with the tamale because you're supposed to have it like warm. So I got a Mexican tamale. It is piping hot right now. Ooh. Okay. Got our bite here. Mamma mia. Sorry guys, I started watching this YouTuber from Italy, and every time he eats something good he's like mamma mia, and that's how I feel right now. It's so good. I'm personally like a really big fan of corn, so I really like it. And it's so comforting, it's so warm and easy to eat, you know? It does need some hot sauce or salsa to accompany it, because without it, it can be a bit dry, but it's delicious. Okay. Let's move on, shall we? Okay, I think I'm gonna try the empanada next. Unfortunately, they didn't have the Bolivian empanadas, which are called saltinas. I looked it up. But I got a Chilean empanada instead, and look how cute it is. They even have, like, it says poulet, which means chicken in French, so I thought that was really cool. Should we do a little food? Okay. I'm personally a really big fan of empanadas. Like, I think I could eat 100 of them. Okay. That's so good. The crust is like flaky and bready at the same time. And I think the Chilean ones are my second most favorite ones, so it's really good. I think there's olives in here, which bring like a really nice saltiness to it, so it's so good. This is the best day ever, guys. Okay. Last, but certainly not least, we've got pupusas. Again, I love pupusas. I got the one with bean and cheese. And what I love about this place specifically for pupusas is that they have like a designated pupusa lady. Like, I've been to this place a lot of times. And every single time, it's this adorable old lady who's making the pupusas. And yeah, you can tell she's an expert. Okay. I want to get a bit of the salsa on there. I want the perfect bite, you know? Ladies and gentlemen, this is what you call the perfect bite. It's so good. First of all, there's no better combination than bean and cheese. Then wrapped in that delicious corn with the coleslaw and the salsa, it's like the perfect food. So overall, everything so good. The pupusa is my favorite one, but everything is so good. Like, you can't, it's like picking a favorite child, you know? Like, who do I pick? Who do I pick? But okay, that meal was absolutely delicious. I honestly wish we could just do a marché on this food tour, to be honest, because everything's just so good there. Anyways, right now I'm at the grocery store that is literally adjacent to the restaurant. Like, you can enter the grocery store from the restaurant and the restaurant from the grocery store. You don't have to go outside. And they have like a bunch of Latin American products and stuff, so it's a really good place to come if you want Latin American products and snacks and stuff. So okay, guys, this is a great place to get jalapenos. It's $2.09 per pound. Yesterday at the grocery store, I paid like, oh, I don't want to say this, but I paid $5 for like 4 jalapenos. Okay, guys, now I am walking towards a grocery store called Sabor Latino, a really popular grocery store. And a little fun fact, actually, I'm gonna tease y'all a little bit. I'm not gonna tell you the fun fact until we get to the grocery store, but yeah, I hope y'all are ready for the little fun fact I'm about to tell you, because it's really, really, really cool. While you're waiting for the fun fact, might as well smash that like button, click subscribe to my channel, and click the bell icon as well, okay? Come on, guys. Come on, we're trying to get monetized here. Tengo una noviecita que solo piensa en quererme a mí y cuida cada mañana de mi jardín. Me
como la miel de naranjo dentro del matorral. Y brinca de flor en flor y me canta de lole lolai.
Okay, now let me tell you guys about the little fun fact that I was talking about. So basically, a grocery store called Los Andes, if I'm not mistaken, opened here. Like, this is where it opened, and then it was bought by Sabor Latino. And that's basically how Little Latin America started, was from this grocery store. So, which is really cool. So we're like in the birthplace of Little Latin America. Very cool. I thought that was very cool. Okay guys, now we're in my favorite section of any grocery store, which is the hot sauce section. And I really personally really like this Buffalo hot sauce, and I see that they have a Chipotle one as well, which I've never tried, so I'm gonna get both. Okay, I thought I'd also mention that they have an entire hot food section as well, and I tried it once, and guys, it was so good. The line right now is pretty big. I'm at a very busy time, so it is very busy right now, so I won't get anything this time, but I just thought you guys should know that if you're ever at Sabor Latino, aside from getting groceries, it is a great place to get hot food, because yeah, it's so good. Okay guys, so now I'm at another really popular restaurant called Impact Taco. They have a bunch of locations all throughout Montreal. And yeah, I've heard that they have all kinds of stuff. So let's go check it out. I've been here once before and I remember it being very good, but I can't remember exactly what I got. Okay guys, we're inside the restaurant now. It is so lively and chaotic and energetic. I'm assuming that's how it is in Mexico. So, I got something that I've never tried before. It's called a huaracha, if I'm not mistaken. It looks like a really long taco. I got it with chicken and there's onions on top, cilantro. And what I really liked about this place is like they have this whole section with like a bunch of salsas and like lemons, and people could just come in and put in whatever they wanted. So I put the whatever she called the spicy sauce, and let's try it. I really hope you guys can hear me. Oh, it should be fine. I have a mic. I'm like screaming. I keep forgetting I have a mic. Okay, moment of truth. Let's try this. I think I have to use my hands. Okay. Cheers. That's really good, actually. And the corn is so good, like the tortilla. It has a really strong corn flavor. I was quiet because it really reminds me of this thing that we have in my culture. It's called dordai, which is like a corn bread. And it really reminds me of that. And the meat, it has like this smoky flavor. Sorry guys, the camera died on me and I ate half of it because I couldn't wait. Sorry. Anyways, what I was saying is what really stands out about this thing is the bread, like the corn tortilla. It's like the texture of it, the flavor of it is really good. The chicken is not very seasoned or flavorful, but it's the toppings, the salsa, the corn that really makes it. And I'm really glad I tried it, and the vibes inside here are super cool. There's like little businesses inside this entire complex. I don't know if they're part of the restaurant or not, but it's really cool and I'm having fun. Okay, you guys know what time it is? It is hot sauce time. I think this is the perfect moment to try the hot sauce that we just got from Sabor Latino. Oh my god, that guy's so good. That's him singing live. Okay, let's try it. Oh! super duper mega illegal. I really like it. Okay guys, it's really cold. Bad day to film this video, but it's okay. Okay, so I came across this place that is selling churros. Look at them. I love churros so much. And I can see that they're filled with dulce de leche, so obviously I had to get it. I mean, how can you not? How can you walk past a churro stand and not get churros? Exactly. So let's bite into it because I think they're warm. It's so good. And what I really like about it, it's not overly sweet. It's literally just perfect. Yeah, I'm a big fan. Yeah guys, I'm a big fan of this churro. It's like, well, I already ate all of it, so can't show you guys much. Sorry guys. But it's filled with dulce de leche and it's so good. I love churros so much. And yeah, it was just like a guy, a father and a son, that had like this little stand set up in front of a grocery store. Like, who would have known? I want more. But yeah. The weather is crazy right now. And it's making me crazy. I wanted to walk around more, but sorry guys. Mother Nature had other plans. Hey guys, it is currently raining. I'm in me mom's car. I'm not in my mom's car, I'm in a car. And we're about to head to my favorite Mexican restaurant. I would say, yeah, I can't think of a better Mexican restaurant that I've been to in Canada. This was actually one of the first restaurants that I went to when I moved to Montreal for the first time. And it blew my mind, guys. Like, I've yet to have better tacos than this place. It is so good. And it is one of the cheapest places I've been to for Mexican food as well, which is crazy. It's called Mexico Restaurant. It's 2 kilometers away from the area that we were just in, the main little Latin America area. And yeah, if you're in Montreal and you're looking for mind-blowing, like mind-shattering, like illegal Mexican food, it's this place. So even though it's raining, we're gonna run to the restaurant and eat some delicious tacos. Vamos, let's go. Tengo una noviecita que solo piensa en quererme a mí y cuida cada mañana de mi jardín. Me llena de caricias, solo en mi huerto quiere vivir. Okay guys, we're inside the restaurant right now and I already knew what I wanted. It's their birria tacos. It is so good. I love birria tacos and this place, they know exactly how to do it. And right now, it's so packed. And oh, something that I should mention. The first time I actually came to this restaurant, it used to be like 2 buildings down and it was this tiny literal hole in the wall, and now they've expanded and they deserve it. I'm so happy to see them succeed because it's so nice to see like small businesses like this like become big, because they truly deserve it. Like, the food is made with so much love and it's so good. Yeah, so now they have like an entire seating area. You can actually come in and sit and eat at the restaurant, but it wasn't like that before, like a couple years ago. So yeah, very cool. So yeah, like I said, I went for the tacos de birria, but everything at this restaurant is really good. I really like the chilaquiles too. I'm a big fan of their chilaquiles, their enchiladas. I've tried them, really good. I've tried their burrito. I've tried their torta. I've practically tried everything and everything is so good. But yeah, the birria tacos are definitely one of my favorites. So that's what I got. And I can't wait. I'm very full though. but there's always room for birria tacos. That's what Albert Einstein said. Okay guys, we got the tacos. First of all, can we just admire how beautiful this looks? This is what I call a masterpiece. This is what I like to call art. Who's Pablo Picasso? Is this what he painted? Because this is what I would go to a museum to see. I'm talking a lot of nonsense today, haven't I? Please ignore me, guys. I am very tired. Okay, so the birria tacos, it comes with the consomme, and you're supposed to dip it in, eat it, and then life is amazing. It's life, yeah. You'll be the happiest you'll ever be. Okay. Oopsies. Okay. Anyways, technical difficulties. Let's try it. So look at that. Look at the cheese in it. Okay. Let's dip it in that. It's made with the pulled beef, by the way. And I love pulled beef. Oh, so good. You'd never think that you could use the phrase melt in your mouth for tacos. But that's exactly what I would say for this. The meat, the cheese, the taco, the consomme, everything is just in harmony. It is perfection. It is amazing. It is amazing. They also gave us some lemons. I know it's supposed to be with lime, but in this economy, guys. Yeah, limes are very expensive right now, which is why they switched to lemons. They also have a sauce here that I'm gonna put on. I call this the taco dance. Yeah, it's so good. I don't know what else to say, it's just so good. Yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite restaurants in Montreal in general. And yeah, the best place for Mexican food. You can't go wrong with it. Like, you can't come here and leave upset and not be satisfied. It's like not possible. If it is, I'll give you $10 million. Okay guys, I am back home now, and as you can see, well, you can't see, I'm in me PJs now. I wasn't lying when I said after that meal all you want to do is sleep. I fell asleep on the car ride home as well. Yeah, anyways, that was an amazing food tour in my opinion. I got to eat one of my favorite things in the world, and it was just perfect. It's unfortunate that the weather was a bit, you know, not ideal, but I had a great time. I'm sorry if I was like a bit flustered, or I don't know. It's just I don't do well with the cold weather, that's all. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this little food tour of Little Latin America in Montreal. I love this community. It has some of the US food, and while I was walking around and driving around, I noticed that there were so many other restaurants that I've never tried before that look so cool. So I thought, I will definitely be doing a part two to this food tour and trying some new places, because I caught so many amazing places. But yeah, overall, if you're ever in Montreal, I highly recommend checking out this area. You won't be disappointed. Anyways, all I'm trying to say is that if you're ever in Montreal and you want amazing Latin American food, you should definitely check out this area. Anyways, I think I'm gonna sign off now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, smash that like button, click subscribe, and also click the little bell ding-a-ling-a-ling to be notified when I post next, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.